Last year, the Big Jingle Jubilee didn't look anything like this. There was nothing like what you see around me. This year, though, it's back, albeit with a little bit of changes, but organizers tell me they're just happy to be here.
We're happy to have everybody here that we can have here today, right?
The holidays last year were odd for Diana Long.
Last year was nothing because it was 2020. Up until last year, for almost 50 years, we had held the Big Jingle Jubilee Holiday Parade.
The parade used to look like this. Now it looks like this. Not a parade, but a festival.
Yeah. I mean, it's still the holiday season, and just because we're not doing a parade doesn't mean we can't do something that helps to get people in the holiday spirit.
But with no parade, it gives other businesses a chance to participate that normally wouldn't. Tanessa Bryant owns Bryant's Barbecue. Last year was also tough for them. Food trucks weren't in demand. Because of that, they jumped on the chance to be here, no matter how many people came.
We've been doing this 15 years, so for us, we come out here with the attitude that we're gonna serve whether we have one person or whether we have 300 people.
And business boomed for them. Plenty of people were enjoying the day. Even Scott Covert made a stop here. And that's what's exciting about today for those here, a chance to get out and see new people.
I've been able to visit with the other vendors. I've been able to visit with my customers. So it's a good day. I call it a good day. Any day above ground is a good day.
So even though this isn't a parade, Long says she hopes it's a good replacement and that they're just happy to be back.
Oh, that was our goal. And so we hope that as people continue to trickle in later this afternoon, as it gets closer to the Capitol lighting, that they enjoy their afternoon and just appreciate that there's an event that they can go to, because we were all stuck inside by ourselves last year and that was no fun.
In Little Rock, Ian Russell, THV 11 News.